go ahead and turn with me to Matthew 9, 16 and 17? Just a second to get there. Okay, and it reads, "No one puts a piece of unshrunk cloth on an old garment, for the patch tears away from the garment, and a worse tear is made. Neither is new wine put into old wineskins. If it is, the skin bursts, and the wine is spilled, and the skins are destroyed. But new wine is put into fresh wineskins, and so both are preserved." Let's pray. Dear Lord, I thank you for this opportunity that you've given me. I pray today as I preach in class that your Holy Spirit would guide me and your words would flow through me, Lord. I pray that as we learn about being careful with what we put into our bodies, this wouldn't just be an assignment that would be here to affect someone. And I thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. In your name, amen. Okay, so have you ever done something that you know wasn't right or consumed a material that you know wasn't good? Whether it be movies, a lot of people like Game of Thrones right now, that's a big thing. Or maybe it's in Westworld, I know there's not some great stuff in that. Or just music in general. I know I'm guilty of this. Listen to a lot of like Kendrick, a lot of rappers that aren't necessarily clean. And just as a personal example, just last night, my roommates and I were blasting music, very profane. The first 10 words are probably swear words. But our other sweet mate comes in and he asks, "Can you guys not listen to music that is so immature that makes you sound like 8-year-olds?" And I was a little bit offended, but after stopping and pausing, I realized, you know what, he has a point. Maybe not, this music isn't immature, but I need to be careful of what I'm allowing into my body, or what I'm taking in. If we are Christians, we are called to a higher calling. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. The old has passed away. Behold, the new has come." Before we were Christians, we weren't under the law. We were on our own. We could more or less get away with doing stuff that wasn't right. But now that we are Christians, we have this higher calling that we need to follow. Just like it says in Matthew 9, 16 and 17, we don't want to put old wine into new wineskin or new wine into old wineskin. When we are saved, we become refreshed, we become new, so we need to be careful what we take in. However, if we do this, there is still hope for us. 1 John 1:9 says, "If we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." I'll be honest, guys, I messed up last night. I shouldn't have been doing what I was doing, but I was, and I've since repented, and I'm working towards getting better at it. It's not going to be an easy thing. It's going to take a while, but I'm working towards it. However, we do need to be careful. We can't just be like, "Oh yes, God will forgive me, I can just listen to this." We have to be cautious, because it says in Hebrews 10:26, "For if we go on sinning deliberately after receiving the knowledge of truth, there no longer remains a sacrifice for sins." So, I mean, that's pretty harsh, but let's be honest, let's think about it. We don't want to intentionally go against the gift that God has been giving us. We don't want to abuse the power of grace. So will you with me today ask God to give you the strength and courage to change the way that you are living your life and to let him guide you? Let's pray. Dear Lord, I thank you for this message again. I thank you for this opportunity. I pray that you would affect the lives of my classmates and even in mine, Lord. I pray that you would continue to guide me along this path that you've set out before me. And I thank you that you knew that I needed this before I even did need it, Lord. Thank you. In your name, amen.